What's going on, everybody? It's Aaron Ducker here with the Necessary Bluntness Sports Talk, and I start off every video by saying, what up, though? This is the channel where I might not tell you what you want to hear, but I'm definitely going to tell you what you need to hear. And I'm back again with another Panthers breakdown video, and we're talking about the kicking situation, the oh-so-messy kicking situation that the Panthers have going on. But before we get into it, you guys make sure you give the video a thumbs up. Pretty please, and make sure you hit the subscribe button, hit the bell icon, because if you don't hit the bell icon, you might not get all the notifications, because YouTube just be hating on the player's channel sometimes, and it don't ever always let everybody know when I drop a video. So if you hit the bell icon, you won't miss a thing. So make sure you hit that bell icon. But real quick, let me know down below in the comments what you think the Panthers should do about the kicking situation. Do you like Graham Gano? Do you like the swole kicker Joey Slye? Let me know down below in the comments. All right, so let's get into it. So going throughout training camp, Graham Gano has been pretty much injured for the most part. They brought in Joey Slye, obviously, to give him a little bit of rest. Now, as the kind of the plot started to thicken as was going on, a lot of people thought that it might have been a kicking competition. Graham Gano signed a contract last year before the 2018 season. He's making about $3.8 million per year, which is one of the highest paid kickers in the league. And it's for good reason. According to some of the fans in the fan base, they do not like Graham Gano because when he does miss, a lot of the misses are untimely. Let's come to mind the Broncos game to open the season, the following season after the Super Bowl year. The playoffs versus the Saints in the wild card round, he missed the field goal. And just last year in Detroit, he missed two extra points. So he's not always a fan favorite, but if you look at the numbers for the past couple seasons, Graham Gano has been one of the better kickers in the NFL. Back in 2017, Graham Gano made 97% of his field goals. That's crazy. This last year, he made a little just under 88% of his field goals. Like I said, his misses were just untimely, and obviously, he's been missing about three extra points per season ever since they moved that line back. So he's still a solid kicker, but like I said, sometimes it can be clutch, sometimes it can be unclutch. We saw him hit that ridiculously long field goal to beat the Giants, but like I said, he missed an easy chip shot field goal in a dome versus the Lions, which could have made the game go one way or another. So Graham Gano is sometimes a mixed bag, but he's been pretty solid, which is why he's been paid as much as he's being paid. So we know he had the knee injury last year, and he actually missed four games. He went on injured reserve the same week pretty much Cam did, and he was out for the remainder of the season, and that's kind of rolled on into this offseason, like I said. Joey Slye, he has spent a couple of times with some other teams, but he's really kicked well this preseason and practices with the team, so it's made the situation a little bit more interesting. And we know how the NFL goes, man. Kickers can be a hot commodity when it comes to the league because just like quarterbacks, there's not enough quality, dependable ones to go around. And they can kind of make or break your team because a lot of these games in the NFL, they come down to the wire. So you need a clutch kicker that can take the points and get you points when you need them. So when you have a good one, you got to hold on to them. But when you got two decent ones that you like in a situation like the Panthers, it can get kind of hectic because you want to keep the best guy, but at the same time, these guys can be head cases, so anything can change at any moment, and you can have a dependable kicker turn into somebody that can be suspect. So Joey Slye has been awesome. He made 6 out of 7 field goals this preseason. The only miss he had was in the last preseason game, and that was because it was a blocked field goal. He's long was a 55-yarder going into that last game, but he hit a 59-yarder that looked like it could have been good from 64, maybe 65, hell, maybe even 66 yards, and he has the leg. He split that long kick right down the pipe, and a lot of people in the fan base, like I said, Graham Gano's rubbed in the wrong way. They like what Slye has brought to the table. Me, myself, it's a tough situation because the Panthers have a few options, okay? Obviously, Graham Gano, he hasn't kicked off preseason. Ron Rivera is worried just because you don't want to put a guy out there when he's healthy if you haven't got a chance to see him kick. But at the same time, you can't carry two kickers. So something's got to give. There's been rumors that Graham Gano could be traded or Joey Slye could be traded. There's been rumors that Graham Gano could go on injury reserve and we hold on Joey Slye. If we put Graham Gano on injury reserve, he'll be there until week 10. So my thought process, why would you do that for a kicker when if you're going on to week 10 and you really think and Joey Slye has been that guy, what do you do at week 10? Do you cut Graham Gano at that point and pay him that money? Because there's no incentive on paying him, cutting him right now because, like I said, he just signed the contract and we'll be paying him anyway. So the option there is to trade him. There are teams that need kickers, obviously. You know, Chicago with the whole Cody Parkey situation that they had last year. The Falcons have been desperate enough to bring in Blair Walsh. And I know they bought in Matt Bryant, all reliable, but anything over 50 yards, he tends to hurt himself. And Tampa Bay, they've had their kicking woes for a while. So they obviously would be open to having the guys like that, but I doubt Marty Herney and Ron Rivera would trade their own kicker into a team in the same division. We saw what happened with Butker a couple years ago, and we tried to practice squad him. He had a solid preseason. We ended up choosing Graham Gano over him, and he ended up getting a deal with the Chiefs. So another situation like this is messy. My thought process is I love Graham Gano. I'm not going to lie. He's one of my favorite guys on the team. Yes, he can be suspect, but I know he has a strong leg. He's a Florida State kicker. They're known for having pretty decent kickers, except for Aguayo, obviously. But I like Graham Gano. He's done a lot for the team, and I don't know. He just fits in jails. He's a good guy, but this is a business. You know what I'm saying? So whoever can give him a better chance, that's going to happen. They're going to be the one that makes the team. But I think somebody does end up getting traded. It may be Slye, but I think they want to be nice to Graham, so they'll end up putting him on injured reserve. I don't like it, though, because he's a kicker. I mean, unless Joey Slye just kind of falls by the wayside and we desperately need Graham to come back by week 10, that'd be okay. But Joey Slye, from what he's seen, he hasn't given us any reason to think that he can't be the guy. So I don't know, man. You guys let me know what you think about the situation. Which one do you think will be the last kicker standing and swinging his leg for us in the regular season? Let me know down below in the comments. But without further ado, I'm Aaron Duncan signing off with Necessary Blunt and Sports Talk. I'll see you next time. Peace.